Okay, now depossessor directories. So in our previous lectures, we discussed there when we write any functions within a main body. So we have to write the header file of that function in the beginning of the program. But today we learned that where we write the header files. Basically, header files are written in pre-processor directives. Okay, and these pre-processor directives starts with the number sign hash. The most commonly pre-processor directives are hash include and hash define. Normally, we use the hash include in our programs. In C language, almost we use the hash include. We don't use the hash define. So in this class, we only learn how to use the hash include preprocessor directives. We don't learn how to use the hash define in C language. Okay, now let's move to the next slide. Hash include preprocessor directive. It has the following syntax: hash include less than sign header file name greater than sign. Okay, now all of you open your books and go to the example which we done in the previous class, and you can check there. We write hash include less than studio dot h greater than sign. So that studio dot h is the header file name. So in previous lecture we only discussed the header file, and today we discuss about the preprocessor directives. So it means header files are the part of the preprocessor directives. Okay, when this preprocessor is carried out by the C compiler, it will search for the header file status written within the less than and greater than symbols. Okay, and copy it into the source file. And what is our source file? Source file is, as our function starts from the main body function after the curly bracket and at the last curly bracket. So between these two curly brackets we have the our main program, and we know that we use the compiler for translating the source code into the object code. So when compiler starts the preprocessor directives, so it searches for the header files. When it checks the header file, then it checks for the all the functions of that header files which we can use in the source program. So C compiler copy this header file to the source program, means the program which is written inside the curly brackets after the main body function. Now when we discuss the example, in that example we write the header file studio.h. now why we use it? Because it tells the compiler to copy the studio.h header file into the program, and studio.h header file stands for the input output operations or headers. Now if we want to display the I love Pakistan, so for displaying the I love Pakistan we have to write printf. So printf is the function of studio.h. so if we use printf in our program, so we have to write the header file studio.h in preprocessor directories. If we don't write the studio.h in our preprocessor directories, so we cannot use the printf in our program. Okay, because printf is the function of studio.h. okay, now if we want to take the input from the user, so let's suppose in chapter number 1 we write the algorithm for painting the table. and for printing the table of a given number, we have to take the number from the user. So when we take a number from the user, or we can say that when we take any thing, any character, any variable, any number from the user, so we have to write the scanf, because scanf is used for the getting something from the user. Okay, scanf is used for getting something from the user. So if we want to get something from the user, so we want to use the scanf. Okay, and again, we only use scanf when we use the header file studio.h, because scanf is also the function of studio.h, and for using the scanf, we must have to write the header file studio.h in our program. I hope today you understand why we use the printf and scanf, and for using the printf and scanf, which header file is required. So which header file is required? Studio.h for the printf and scanf. Now, most commonly used the function for printing something on screen is printf. Whenever in our program we have to display the anything on our screen, so we use the printf. Okay, let's take an example. Let's suppose we want from the user to get the age of a student. Okay, or we can say that we want to get the date of birth of any student. So first of all, we have to display a message on our screen. Which message? The message in which we write, please enter the date of birth of the, let's suppose, name Hamza. Okay, so please enter the date of birth of Hamza. So first of all, we have to display this message on our screen. So for displaying anything on our screen, we use printf. We use printf, and when a user see this message, then he will give us some date. Let's suppose 29. Okay, so for getting something from the user, we use scanf. Then user enter the 29 and we will get that 29. So for getting something from the user, first we use the printf for displaying the message on the screen, and then for getting something from the user, we use the scanf. Okay, now let's move to the next slide. Main function. What do you mean by the main functions? In our previous lectures, we only discussed about the main function is written after the preprocessor directories. When we write a program in C language, our first step is writing the preprocessor directives. Start with the hash. And also you can see from your books, when we solve the example, we write hash include studio.h void main brackets and then curly bracket. Now, void main is the main function. Void main, when we write the void main and two parentheses, so it means that is the main function in our program. Okay, now, what is the function of this main function? Okay, the question is, what is the function of this main function? Why we say that this is the main function, or why we call this main function? Okay, three questions in our minds. Why we call this main function? Because let's suppose we have to solve an example. Okay, so the example is, we have to take the date of birth of any student and print the result and in result we will display how many years, of his old. Let's suppose he Hamza, date of birth of Hamza is 15 April 2000. Okay, so now Hamza is 20 year old. Okay, 20 year old. So in our program we have to get the date of birth from the user and we have to display the age of Hamza, means 20 years old. So in any function we have to display our results. So what is the purpose of this main function? Main function's purpose is, in this main function we declare that which type of data we take the input from the user. Main function tell us, this main function tell us which type of data we get from the user. Okay, then this main function also tell us which type of data we will give to the user after the processing. After the processing, which type of data we will provide, or we consider we will give to the user. Okay, this is a second type. So these both things can be learned from the main function. Okay, so it means a function perform a single well-defined task. Every C program must have the main function, because without the main function C programs cannot be executable. Okay, keep it in your mind, every C language program must have the main function. If C language program don't have any main function, so it means it cannot be executable. For execution of the C language program we must have main function. Okay, now normally we use the void main, and parenthesis. Okay, in our previous lecture when we solved the example, we don't write here void. You can see in your books, we don't write here void. In example, only we have void main. We don't have any void. So what are the meanings of this void and this void? Okay, or we can say that what is the purpose of this void and this void in our programs. Okay, in our program when we write here void main, so first void in the main function means that the function does not return a value. Okay, the function does not return a value, as we learned in previous lecture, I love Pakistan. So we write the void main. So it means when the program will execute, it does not return anything to the user, because in that program we only use the printf and I love Pakistan, which display the message on screen and nothing else. Okay, nothing else. So it means this void is used for to understand for the user which type of data functions will provide after the execution. Okay, what is the purpose of this next void? This next void is used for, which is written inside the brackets, it means that it does not have any argument. It does not have any arguments. But after some lectures, when we write a different types of program in our C language, so we change them. We can write here void main int. We can write here int main void. We can write here float main int, anything. And what do you mean by int, float? After some lectures you will learn what do you mean by the int and float. Okay, so but today, in today's lecture we only discuss what is the purpose of this void main void. And if we write here int, so what is the purpose of int? Int means, if we write here int main, so the program after the execution will provide the data according to the int. Int means numerical data. Okay, so let's start to the next slide. Third thing is body of main functions. Body of main functions. We also discussed about the body of main function in our previous lecture. But in our previous lecture, we only discuss about the header files, main function, body of main function. And now today we again discuss about these three topics, but in detail. Today we discuss in detail the preprocessor directories. Second thing is main function. Now we will discuss about the body of the main function. Okay, now what do you mean by the body of main function? First of all, from where we start the body of main function? So body of main function starts after the main function. And we see there, after the main function, we write a curly bracket, this bracket. Okay, so it means when we write the curly bracket, so after this curly bracket, we start the body of main function. Okay, after this curly bracket, any statement or anything which we written in the program that require the body of main function. And until on the end, we write this curly bracket. Okay, when we write the on the end this curly bracket, it means here the body of main functions is end. So it means the body of main functions written inside the these two curly brackets. Anything which is written inside these curly brackets that are called the body of main functions. Okay, but some students do the mistake here when they write the main function, and after the main function they have to write this curly bracket, this first curly bracket, but they put this curly bracket, closing curly bracket. So it means their program cannot be executable because it has the error. So first of all, he have to remove their error. So it means we can replace these brackets. We cannot replace these brackets. For the starting of main body function, we only write this curly bracket. For ending, we have to write this curly bracket. We don't replace these curly brackets. If we replace these curly brackets, so it means our programs have the error in our C language program. Okay, so for the starting of the program, we must write this curly bracket, and for ending of the program in C language, we must have to write this closing curly bracket. Okay, now the body of the function in the program consists of a single statement, printf, which ends with a semicolon. Okay, now what is the purpose of semicolon? Okay, the word used here, semicolon. What is the purpose of this semicolon in the main body function? What is the purpose? The purpose is whenever we write the any statement in our main body function, the body of the main function, whenever we write any instruction, so after the instruction we must write this semicolon. If we don't write the semicolon, it means our program have the error. So for the execution of program, first of all we have to remove those errors. Okay, so it means in the body of function, every statement, each and every statement must have the semicolon. Okay, semicolon. And second thing is whenever we have to display something on the screen, whenever we have display something on screen, so we use the printf. But we use printf, but in printf how we write a statement? Let's suppose we write I love Pakistan. So For displaying the I love Pakistan, we must use the double quotes. Okay? Let's suppose in our English essay or anything, when we have to write some important thing, so we write them in inverted commas. Starting inverted commas and ending inverted commas. Okay? So now again, in C language program, whenever we have to display something on our screen, so we first of all we use the printf, brackets, and in brackets we write the message in the form of quotes. Means we write the message, and from the start of message we have to write the inverted commas, and at the end of message we also have to write the inverted commas. If we don't write this inverted commas and we don't put the semicolon at the end of the statement, so our program have the errors. So first of all we remove errors. Okay, and semicolon is also known as the terminator of the statement. Okay, semicolon is also known as the terminator of the statement. I hope now you understand what is the body of the main function. Okay, now today we discuss about the comments in C language. Okay, today we discuss about the prepossessor directives, main body function, and the body of the main function. Three: prepossessor directives, header files, main function, the body of main function in detail. Now we discuss about the comments in C language. Okay, why we use the comments, or we can say that what is the purpose of comments, where we use the comments. These three questions we have in our minds. First is why we use comments, where we use comments, what is the purpose of these comments. Okay, now we know that whenever we ask anyone, let's suppose I ask you to give comments on this lecture. Okay, so when you give comments on this lecture, so in comments you will ask different things. Okay, so I can understand what is the why we discuss about comments in C language, why we discuss about prepossessor directives, or what are we discussing in this lecture. I can learn from the comments. Okay, so in the C language program, or C language can provide us the facility for writing the different type of comments in our program, and the compiler ignores these comments. The compiler does not compile these comments and does not execute the program according to these comments. Okay, these comments are not executable by compiler. Keep it in your mind. Okay, second thing is where we write the comments. We can write the comments in the mid of program, in the start of program, anywhere you can write comments. Okay, but where we normally use, mostly we use the comments in the beginning of our program. Now the question is, why we use the comments in the beginning of our program? Why? That is another question in our minds. Because in our program, when we write the, or when we explain about the, when we starting to explain about the programs, okay? So we write the comments in the beginning of program. So from the comments, we can learn which type of program today discuss. Which type of program today we will discuss. Because when we write a program, the only programmer can understand why we write this program. But let's suppose I write the program for printing at the table. So how you understand this program is writing for the printing of a table? You can understand when I can tell you. Okay, otherwise you can't understand why we write this program. So when I write some comments in the beginning of program, so when you read those commands, you can easily learn why we write this program or what is the purpose of this program. Okay, now there are two types of commands: single line commands and multiple line commands. Now, what do you mean by the single line commands? The single line commands means in these commands we only write the single line. Okay, single line, and the syntax of these commands means the rules of these commands, or you can see how we write this command. For writing the commands, first of all we have to draw these two bars, then comment. Example is bars programmer Mohammed Sajid Haider. Anything. Okay, here multiple line commands. In multiple line commands, we write the multiple lines by using these syntax. For example, first line and static programmer Mohammed Sajid Haider programming language C, date program was written 7/1/2019, and end. This is the syntax for writing the comments. Here is the example. Okay, first of all, now in this one example, we will discuss all our lecture. Now, this is the preprocessor directories. Okay, in this preprocessor directories, we have this. This is known as the header file name. Okay, our next thing. Next is, this is known as the main function. This is known as the main function. Okay, next. Next is, this is known as the body of the main function. Okay, now comments. So this is the single line comments. Okay, these are also known as the single line comments. Okay, and now where we use the semicolon, here after the each line we must use the semicolon. Okay, our whole lecture covered in just single example. Okay, now if you have any problem or any question related to today's topic, you can text me.